Hey guys, it's James Chick again. Today I'm out on location at Indent Studios and we're shooting some green screen footage, if you couldn't tell, for a trailer for a script called Varsity Cheerleader Werewolves from Outer Space. And yes, that is an actual script that's in pre-production right now. And we're putting together this trailer based off of the original Alien trailer with the egg and the space and that whole thing. The reason we're doing that is because, you know, Prometheus just came out, so we're trying to ride the coattails of that buzz, get people excited about this project. I hope you guys enjoyed this trailer, and if you haven't seen it yet, you should check it out right there. And if you haven't seen the original Alien trailer, which this is based off of, you should click on a link right there. And the writer for this project, or for this script, was called Steve Coker. You may recognize him from some of our earlier projects, such as Epic Villain, where he plays a Hannibal Lecter-type character in the orange jumpsuit. He's a really hilarious guy. He's a great writer. You guys should get excited about this project and look forward to it when it comes out later. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy some of this behind-the-scenes stuff, and I'm going to go ahead and show you a little bit of how I put it together in After Effects, and then maybe later on I'll release a video doing more of a detailed breakdown, because we do some cool stuff utilizing CS6 new 3D rendering engine with some cool text with reflections and opacity and all that kind of stuff. So anyways, hope you guys enjoy.
So here you can see the green screen footage reshot of the cheerleaders, and this isn't an ideal setup for green screen because, as you can see at the bottom, there's that hard line and then they're standing on cement instead of on a green screen, which means there's a lot of rotoscoping to cut out their feet. So ideally you'd be shooting against a green psych wall, that way you can key it out and don't have to worry about rotoscoping. Unfortunately, this was shot before they finished their psych wall, so it just meant more work for me in post. And here you can see the tilt down onto our football in front of the green screen of the backside, and then you can see here, there's the front side where he kicked it off.
So now that everything's been shot and actually already put together, it's been about a month since we shot at Indent Studios. Hopefully you guys have already seen the project so you know what we're talking about, but we're going to take a look here and see how I set up the trailer for Varsity Cheerleader Werewolves from Outer Space. One of my favorite things about this project was that it was really not much to begin with. There was a couple green screen plates and some still images that we got. That was about it. And then I got to take that and put it together and try and make something cool out of it. So it was a really fun project for a compositor VFX guy because it kind of tested your creativeness, because there wasn't a whole lot of guidelines. There were some really simple storyboards, which you can see right here, but they were just really quick roughed out sketches. So I got to take those and take the couple green screen plates that we shot and create something cool out of it. So let's take a look here and see how I set it up, and I'll even show you some of the new features in CS6, such as the 3D text.
Alright, so now that we're inside of After Effects here, let's go ahead with the comp fully set up, switch into a 3D view, just so you guys can see how I set this up. I went for a very three-dimensional setup in this. I created a camera and positioned everything in 3D space, so that way I basically recreated our camera move of the tilt down from space. Let's rotate around. We have all these different things in 3D space. Here's my camera up here. There we go. And then my football up in the foreground, and my tree layers in the medium, and then my moon, and then my stars. So this is all set up in 3D space, so I can manipulate the camera move however I want, which is great. It's like actually being out on location. I can decide to change things, reposition. I could have completely changed the camera move if I wanted to go left or right, whatever. So that's a really beneficial way to set this up, is actually recreating your scene in 3D, and then it makes it really simple for making changes or doing timing changes, like if we wanted the tilt down to be 5 seconds instead of 2 seconds or something like that. It's really easy to do just with a couple keyframes. So let's go ahead and jump back out to my active camera, camera 1. Alright, now that we're back in our current camera 1 view, we can just scrub through the timeline here so you guys can kind of see how I have it set up. Starts up at the stars, tilts down to reveal the moon, the trees, got some cool flares on the side, which is Video Copilot's optical flares. Always plug those guys whenever I can. Tilt down to reveal the egg, which is actually a football, you guys know, and it transitions to the football, gets kicked, rack focus to reveal our cheerleaders in the background. So let's just jump back to the beginning here. These stars were done really simply, just creating a black solid and then adding a fractal noise to it. And then once we add that fractal noise, you can just boost the contrast, push down the brightness of it to give it that real nice starry sky look. And I added a glow to it just to give it a little bit extra glow and put a levels adjustment on it here just to bring up the blacks, because I felt like it was too black with the current one. You can see right there before the levels and then after the levels. And then I just pushed those way back in Z space and positioned them so that way when you tilt it down, they moved very slowly in the background compared to your foreground to give you that nice parallax. And the moon is the same basic process. I got a nice image of a moon, cut it out, got it in 3D space and positioned it behind my trees, but in front of my stars, so that when I tilt it down, I could get the correct camera movement of it. My tree layer here, there it is right there. I just pre-comped this nice images of a trees, mirrored it to give it enough width for me and give it a nice V focusing down in the middle. And that was just positioned in 3D space again, in front of my stars and in front of my moon, but behind my football. Let's jump into this football comp, because this is probably the most detailed part of it, where we went and we shot on green screen our football, and you can see we just shot the back side of it because we didn't want to actually see the laces, because we wanted to have the appearance of the egg and not a football. But when he kicks it, we shot the front of the football with the laces. And what we did is we hid that transition using the floodlights out here from our stadium. So you can see the floodlights are off, but then we get a big, nice big flash, which hides our transition from the back to the front of the football. And then he goes and kicks it away, and we rack focus with our 3D camera to reveal our cheerleaders, which we shot on our green screen, positioned on the floor back in Z-Space. And we get some nice shadows by creating 3D lights behind them and casting them on our ground plane image of the football field. So this is a really fun little project with just a bunch of 2D elements. No 3D was required in this. It's all 2.5 After Effects 3D setup. And I think it's a fun little project. And then once I had all this done, I kicked that final sequence out and created a new After Effects project to do my 3D titles. We can jump over to Premiere here so you can see what those look like. So these titles were also done in After Effects, but I did them afterwards because the 3D rendering of the text is pretty heavy, even if you have a pretty big beefy system, like I'm running a 16 core with 64 gig of RAM, and it still kind of gets bogged down. So it was best to kick out my sequence of all the cheerleaders and everything comped together and then create a new project where I did all my text. And then I could set my environment map of my background and all that in there for the correct 3D reflections and refractions and all that. And I'm actually going to do another breakdown in detail about how I did that 3D text, because I think there's a lot of interest in it and it's pretty deep, so it's going to take a while just to go over the text. I'm not going to worry about the cheerleaders or anything. I'm strictly going to focus on the 3D text in CS6. Because that's a great new feature. It keeps you from having to go to Cinema 4D or whatever, and you can just do it all inside of After Effects and get really nice 3D text with different textures and translucencies and reflections and all sorts of fun stuff. So you guys have to wait a few weeks for that to come out, but I think it'll be a good one once we get it done. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.